I never killed anybody, but I got something to do with that body. I got this grease on my back, carry it like I'm moving about it. I told him to shoot 100 rounds, like he trying to move it about it. It was like 11 in the morning, skip to school, that's a truancy about it.
That's Young Thug's hit song, Anybody. Well, as you probably know, his Rico trial is now underway, and several high-profile witnesses, including rapper Killer Mike and a sitting Atlanta City Council member, could possibly be called to testify. Now, all eyes are on the trial, as the rapper's own musical lyrics could be used against him, which could have far wider implications. Young Thug, whose government name is Jeffrey Williams, is amongst 14 defendants who are being charged in a sweeping gang-style indictment that targets members of the, quote, Young Slime Life gang, also known as YSL. Now, prosecutors allege that Young Thug was one of the founders of YSL, which is being accused of committing very violent crimes, including murder and robbery, going all the way back to 2013. Now, in addition to the RICO and gang charges, he's also being accused of violating Georgia's Controlled Substances Act, and he has some weapons charges. Young Thug has pleaded not guilty, and his defense attorneys say that YSL is a record label and it's a clothing company. It is not a gang. 28 people were originally charged, but 8 have already taken plea deals, and they are expected to testify against him. Yes, this includes rapper Gunna, who was released from custody last month. Wow, the streets are definitely talking about this one. So, of course, I had to call the big guy to talk about it with me is none other than radio host Mo Kelly. Mo Kelly, thank you so much for being with us. Everybody's talking about this. What are your callers? What are people saying? What are you hearing about this high-profile case?
There are a number of things. One, I would say Young Thug is in trouble because you have all the plea deals. You have associates, if you will, who are probably going to be testifying against him. That is problematic. But more people are talking about the idea of using lyrics as part of the case against Young Thug. And the lyrics have already been read into the trial. The jury has already heard that. And so you can't unhear it. You can't unring that bell. And with that in mind, it has implications for not only this case, but music more widely and generally, and legally more widely and generally.
Yeah, I agree, but I do think that the kind of social media conversation and even the, you know, traditional media outlets, television, news, and radio are focusing on the lyrical part. And I get why, because I think that part feels particularly triggering to people that enjoy art, right? That enjoy the creativity that artists are rightly permitted to express, things that may be true and things that may just be fantasy or fiction, right? But I can't help but, Mo, focus in on the fact that when you read, first of all, if you have not already watched or listened to the judge in this case, who happens to be a black man of, I would say, no more, Mo, than probably early to mid 50s. And I think that's important because I think there is some level of cultural competency from the judge hearing this case. And I think, again, when you look at the facts of a case like this, that's important. You should hear the judge read them. I think he did that, Mo, to get that part out of the way. And I think that this judge is going to be focused on the 181 acts, not lyrics, not song, you know, titles, the acts, Mo Kelly, that are really being charged here. So what do you think about the shift in focus?
No, I agree with you. And if Young Thug is going to be found guilty, it will be on the merits and the specifics, the overt actions, but I also look at the wider implications of how it may not be the deciding factor in this case, going back to the lyrics, but it's going to have implications for other cases, for other rap artists, if you will, who won't be before this particular judge. And that's why it's of great concern to me. But when you think about the closeness or coziness of a lot of these supposed alleged criminal acts and hip hop, it goes back many, many years. And also, the reputation of hip hop is also on trial specifically here. And yes, the record label can allege, hey, we're just a record label. We have nothing to do with this. But as someone who's worked in the music industry, that historically has never been the case, where if you're working in close concert with someone, no pun intended, you kind of know what they're doing, having nothing to do with their music.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to throw stones and hide your hands, particularly in the music business, as you say, Mo. Now, before we go on to the next topic, I do need you to weigh in on this, Mo Kelly. This is an update that we want to give to a story that we have been following. The suspect charged in the murder of Amigos rapper Takeoff has been released on a $1 million bond. 33-year-old Patrick Clark will have to wear an ankle monitor as a part of this release agreement. Clark's original bond was set at $2 million, but his attorneys argue that that was too high. Judge reduced it to $1 million. Prosecutors have alleged that he was a flight risk, and according to court docs, Clark has a large amount of money, cash, on him when he was taken into custody. A lot to go through here. They did require him to turn in his passport, Mo. Just how are you feeling about his release?
I'm ambivalent, if only because the specifics of this alleged crime suggest to me that he is a flight risk, that he may be a danger to the community.
Yes.
And not to cast aspersion on anybody else, but this particular case suggests that remand would have been in order. I am not the attorney, but I am clear that he is a flight risk and he has means. And just because you turn in your passport doesn't mean that you don't disappear.
Absolutely right. Listen, if I'm on that bench, Mo Kelly, it's remand. If heaven forbid this defendant commits anything that is of danger to the community while he is out, that blood will be on this judge's hands. Make no mistake about it. Mo Kelly's going to stay with us, y'all, so we can talk about what is next in the culture, including Bill Cosby. Yes, Bill Cosby is returning to the stage in 2023. Yes, you heard that right. Hear what he's now revealed to one radio host about a possible tour. Stay with us.
New on the Grio, masters of the game.
My very first play, my name wasn't on the marquee. I was, you have to take it down. I need my name up there. And they thought it was arrogance, but the truth is I was building a brand. As a black person in Hollywood, I'm not going to get a lot of chances if something doesn't work. I had to do what worked, build my business, build my studio, and get to a place where I'm completely self-sustainable. So that now I'm at a place where I'm comfortable enough to say I'm going to do all the things that I've wanted to do all these years.
Every Friday at 8 p.m. right here on The Grio.